Hello everyone, and welcome to the most highly requested foundation review at the moment here. I have got the new NYX Total Control Foundation, Drop Foundation, if you want to be completely accurate to the title of this stuff. Basically, from what I know, this is supposed to be a foundation where, like, you can use just three drops of it, and it's supposed to be four drops if you want complete full coverage, blah blah blah. So yeah, I mean, you guys want me to test it, so here I am. I can definitely do that for you. I ordered mine from Ulta not too long ago and it finally came in the mail, so here we are, time to test it. Before I do anything else, let's go on over to the NYX website probably. We can read about the product and see what all of its claims are other than being a drop foundation type of a thing. Let's do that before I put it on my face and then we can actually get on into putting it on my face. Like I said, this is the NYX Total Control Drop Foundation. It comes in 24 different shades and will set you back $14. You do only get 0.43 fluid ounce of product in this. In terms of colors, it looks like we have got anywhere from pale on over to deep espresso. I mean, it looks decently deep, I would say, especially for a drugstore range. Obviously not the deepest it could go, and obviously not the palest it could go, but you know, it doesn't look too bad. And of course, there is a whole slew of medium type shades in between. But what this is, it's a sheer to full ideal coverage foundation that is just drops away. You can fine tune this velvety matte foundation with the included dropper by adjusting the number of drops until you create the look you're feeling today. Want more coverage? Add more drops. And to apply, just buff it in. Of course, they're trying to sell their Total Control Drop Foundation brush, but they do seem to suggest using a brush for a seriously smooth finish. Does anyone else's cats do this when you're like doing laundry and all of your bed sheets? Aside from my backdrop here, but like they go nuts for a blank mattress. I don't know what it is. But alright, anyways, it is time to put this on my face, so let's go ahead and sing the song together, and then we can get on into doing just that. Let's test, hot mess or the best. Right, time to get you zoomed in a bit. Get my hair out of my face. If you are new to my channel, hello there, I'm so happy to have you here. But I give this spiel every time I test out a foundation. First off, I do wash and moisturize my face before I film the video. And I also do like to use a primer when I test out a foundation. I know, controversy abounds with this, but this is just how I personally like to do it. I find that this is the best way for me to test it out. Someone did correct me. It is getting rid of confounding variables, not the addition of extra independent variables or whatever, like I typically say. So I just try and get rid of any confounding variables. You know, I always use a primer, just always with a foundation. So for me, figuring out, you know, does the foundation work? Does it not work? This is the best way for me to do it. So I'm sorry for those of you that don't like that, but that's just how I find the best results. And then I also do like to test out foundations with my glasses on for the fellow glasses wearers of the world out there. We can see how the foundation wears underneath our glasses pads and also where our glasses tend to touch our face throughout the day. So now that primer is on, let's go ahead and test this out. I'm so excited. I got mine in the shade Porcelain. I was really not sure which shade I should get. It's hard when a foundation or product is new like this because swatches online are really not available. Oh boy. Pretty sure this is gonna be way too light on me. Okay, I was kind of scared about that, but you know, it is what it is. This is what I got. So I'm just gonna work with it. So the box said to shake well. It does sound very liquidy. Can you hear that? I hope that was very well, but there you go. Reiterate, I got the shade Porcelain. So I guess, I mean, I'm just assuming that this is like a dropper and it's gonna drop stuff. It does look very liquidy, as you can see there. Maybe, of course, it probably wasn't focused on the foundation, but ooh, I do like that. I don't know that you're gonna be able to see inside of there very well, but it's got like a little holder, like a placeholder for the dropper. I don't know that that really makes a difference, but I like, you know, attention to detail, that sort of a thing. So gonna go ahead, scoop some of the, well, not scoop, but, okay, so I don't really, like, do I put it on the brush? Do I put the drop on my face? It says to do 2 drops for light, 3 drops for medium, and 4 drops for full. Is that really for the whole face? I feel like I'm putting eye drops in or something. It's kind of hard to, like, noink. Oh, that's very liquidy. I mean, what was I expecting? It just feels like I put water on my face. You can see it dripping down. Go ahead, blend this in. Okay, so it does look like, yeah, I mean, it looks like that was pretty accurate for 2 drops. I mean, granted, if I were, is that the brush or is that the foundation? My goodness. But I mean, I can't imagine if I were to do the 2 drops for my whole face, that would give 0 coverage if you ask me. Looks like a typical, at least on the one half of my face with the 2 drops, it looks like a typical light coverage foundation. I don't know, something about the foundation smell. It's like, it's not a bad smell, it just smells like foundation. But, oh, well, okay. I guess my brow's getting that drop. Great, exactly where I don't want it. So I'm just adding another drop because light coverage isn't exactly what I want today, but it looks like it blends in really quickly and very nicely. I can definitely feel that it has a matte finish to it. It feels liquidy going on, but it doesn't feel like hydrating when it's going on. But yeah, it just looks really lightweight and natural looking, right? I mean, there's the one half of my face with the foundation and the one half without. Zoom in a little bit more. I don't love the way that it's looking in my nose pores, so we'll see when I do this other half of my face how it ends up looking with a sponge. So there's 1 drop. 2 drops. Because, you know, it's hard too, because how much is a drop, you know? How long does one hold the dropper to drop out the foundation? Like, are we talking one hole, like you squeeze until it completely comes out and that's considered a drop? I mean, I don't know. I guess it's gonna depend on the person. I like the sponge side better when it comes to my nose pores. But I feel like I like the way it looks on the rest of my face with a brush. You know, some foundations I just really do like to use both a brush and a sponge. You know, why not? Make everyone feel loved and used in the best way possible. There you go. I would say I did about 4 drops on my whole face overall. Kind of, you guys, I have no idea. You saw how many I did, but I think I did like the medium coverage of the foundation. So just for funsies, I'm gonna see about just building it up a little bit more on my cheeks. Looks like little sad teardrops. Blend it out, see how coverage is. I mean, it really does look like it builds well on top of itself. Like, wherever you are wanting more coverage, it will do that for you. And there we go, there it is. You can really see I was able to get it nice and built up. Covered tons of redness and darkness underneath my eyes and on my cheeks and my nose. I'd say I did more of like a medium finish on my forehead. I'm not so sure. I mean, I am sure that I've got some dry spots on my forehead, so it looks like this might not be the greatest foundation if you have dry skin, but overall, I think it looks pretty nice, right? I mean, it's hard for me to tell without my glasses on here, but overall, I really don't think that it looks cakey or anything. It blended in well, etc., etc. Let's see, the big test. Vision? This is so pale on me. Oopsies. I mean, it's not pale to the skin that, like, never sees the sun, but the skin that does see the sun, like my neck, yeah, this is a little pale on me. But, you know, that's okay. I'm hoping I'll make it work with blush and everything on. It's really, really soft. Like, delightfully soft on my face. I really like the way that this feels, but it also feels like if I push like even slightly harder, you know, I'm like pretending like I'm touching a baby, just like ultra soft and gentle. I feel like if I use any more pressure than that, it's just gonna like wipe right off. So I'm a little nervous about that. But overall, here it is. This is what it looks like so far. I'm gonna go ahead and do the rest of my makeup here, and then I will come back and we can check in, see how it looks and everything. I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and I will be back in just a second to check in with you all here on YouTube land. Ready? Ding! All right, so it's been a little while since I've put this on, maybe like an hour or so. I just have been like, I've got like, I'm trying to clean my bathroom, I'm trying to get laundry done, et cetera, et cetera. And it's just like, I'm trying to do way too many things at once here. But either way, here's the foundation. I know I really didn't do much of anything with my makeup today, but this is what it is. I'm nervous because I can already see the horrendousness of it underneath glasses. I'm dreading this for around my nose, on my chin, you know, places that the foundation typically wipes off of me and everything throughout the day. Otherwise, you know, I think it looks fine. It does look very matte and everything on my forehead and my cheeks and whatnot, but I'm dreading this foundation right now. There it is, a little closer up for anyone who cares about it, you know, in the nose pores and whatever else you might be wanting to see with it. I also didn't think that it looked bad with the flash or anything. As you can see on the screen here, it does look very pasty, but like I was saying earlier, I'm pretty sure that's just because this is way too pale of a shade for me. That really isn't from flashback or anything. That's just from an incorrect shade choice on my part. But you know, I think it looks good in the photo from what I can tell, so there is that. Otherwise, I'm just gonna get on with my day, try and get all of my household duties that I'm trying to get done, get those done. I am also going to be testing out a lip product today, so I need to film this video. And yeah, I think that's about it for now. It's going to just be a day for me. I'm going out with some friends later. We're gonna go bowling. Otherwise, I just need to get some work done, get my chores done, have a typical day. But as always, I'm excited to bring you guys along with me to see how this foundation ends up wearing, the good, the bad, the ugly, whatever it ends up being. I will check in with you all whenever it seems pertinent throughout the day, slash every 3 or 4 hours-ish, so that we can see how this foundation is doing. It is currently 2:26 in the afternoon. I will just see you all very soon here on YouTube land. Bye! Sorry, yikes, I know. So I did unexpected grocery shopping after I did all of my other stuff this afternoon. It is currently 19 in the evening. Like I was saying, I did laundry, changed the bed sheets, scrubbed the tub, scrubbed the bathroom in general, and then I went to my P.O. box, and then I went grocery shopping, and here I am, and oh my gosh, I'm so sweaty and so tired. I hate carrying groceries up to my apartment, but that just means it is time for some blotterazzi action because the sweat was real. My face needs more than a blotting sheet right now. Here it is. Do I look real flushed? That's because it's 5 degrees outside and I was sweating. I can see foundation all over my glasses pads, so yeah, that's definitely, that's a mess. I feel like I'm failing all over the place right now, but there we go. So I'm gonna go ahead. Oh, yes. Soak it all up, blotterazzi. Soak it all up. Oh. So needed. All right, so there we go. It is all blotted up. That's what it looks like now. Even more zoomed in, how about? So there it is. It's starting to definitely look quite, drying, I guess, like around my nose and on my forehead, but it doesn't look like horrible. I mean, I'm not gonna be embarrassed when I go out tonight, but I mean, it's a look in any case. So yeah, I think that is about it for now. I mean, earlier, like when I was grocery shopping and stuff, I wasn't feeling greasy or anything, and like this still feels ultra super silky smooth on my skin, so it does have that going for it. I'm just not crazy about how it looks close up in person here, but you know, oh well. I'm gonna get on with my night. I'm gonna cook myself some dinner for the whole week and for tonight, and then I'm going out with friends, like I said, and then coming home and editing a video. I'll probably check in with you guys before I leave, question mark? I mean, in any case, it'll be in a few hours here on YouTube land, so I will see you all very Alright, hello everyone, good evening. It is the end of the night here, or at least close enough to the end of the night.
It is currently 1:21 in the morning.
I was thinking I was gonna edit a video once I got home, but I'll do it tomorrow. I'm tired and I'm ready to take this foundation off of my face. It wasn't my favorite. Like, do we need to zoom in? Alright. Can you see it like completely rubbed off of my nose? It looks really cakey, like, around here. You see that? And, like, on my chin. I am looking a bit shiny, so, I mean, I guess we can see. It, like, yeah, it comes off on the blind sheet. Can you see that? It comes off in, like, little pilly bits, almost. Ooh. That's no good. Yeah, I just don't really like the way that it broke down and how it wore. I suppose I can take my glasses off. Definitely don't like the way that it looks underneath my glasses pads. Can you see? I know I can't right now, but can you see like where the foundation came off on my glasses there on the rims? That is no good. So yeah, I don't know. This foundation just doesn't seem to be the one for me. I don't know if it's just because I have oily skin or what the case may be, but it's just, eh. The one thing I will say that it has going for it is that the texture is really nice and silky soft, so it. A lot of you wanted me to come up with like some sort of a rating system, and so since I have cats, I should make the paws system, grading system, okay? Stay with me. P for price, A for application, W for wear, and then S for shade range. Those are the things that I really look for in a product, especially with a foundation. So I figure I can do everything out of 5, like a 1 through 5, 1 being the worst, or hey, even a 0 through 5. So 0 being the worst and then 5 being the best. So for price, I'm gonna give it right in the middle. I'll give it a 3. Application, I think, is a little bit difficult with the dropper to like get it on your face and everything, but it did end up blending out really easily and whatnot. So I will say that the application was decent. Maybe that I'll also give a 3. The wear overall for me was not so great. I'd give it a 2. I mean, it hung in there. Like, it wasn't the worst thing ever, but I mean, it wasn't that good. And then the shade range, it looked pretty decent. Like, I would give it, I don't know. What would you guys say? Maybe a 4 for the shade range? Crap. What did I say? 4, 3... Nope. 4, 2, 3, 3. So this got a 12 out of 20 for me. Not the best, hence why I'm like, meh. But, you know, there is a chance that I might be able to use this in the future. I'm thinking I might use this as kind of like a lightening slash mattening device. I'm gonna see how it works mixed into some of my other foundations. But other than that, it really wasn't the greatest. I think that is gonna do it for me for this foundation review. As always, I hope it was helpful and or enjoyable for you to see how this foundation did on my skin. Maybe this is gonna be something you will or will not want to try out for yourself. If it was, please do go ahead and give me a thumbs up down below. I'd really appreciate it. And if you're new here, hey, hi, hello, how are you? You can go ahead and subscribe if you want to see more content from me in the future. I would love to have you here. And as always, I just hope you guys are all doing well. And until next time, just stay well until then. Bye!
this club, right?